Greetings everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about GCT and CLS files, which are used to perform GSEA analysis and how to make them manually. After obtaining the normalized count data file, we can start prepare our GCT and CLS files. A GCT file in GSEA analysis is used to represent gene expression data. It is a tab-delimited text file that contains normalized gene expression measurements for multiple samples and multiple genes. The file includes a header line that specifies the number of rows and columns. The rows are the genes, and columns are the samples. Rows of data containing the expression values for each gene in each sample. Firstly, let's make the GCT file. In the first line, #1.2, which is the version string. So, we need to shift the first row. This insert, and then entire row. So here, I have to write #1.2. And then, we write the size of the data, which is the number of the gene IDs. Let's just check the number of the gene IDs in our data. In our data, it's 24,388 gene IDs. Now we have also to shift the second entire column. Is insert as an entire row. To put here, number which is 24,388. Then in the title cell of the gene IDs, we write name capitalized here. Then, in the second column, we write description and we fill the cells under this column with NAs. So, here, have to shift this whole entire with description. And write here in. And then, we track until the last cell in the column. Here inside the number of gene IDs, we write the number of samples. In our case, we have 4 samples, so we write 4. Regarding CLS file, it is used to define the phenotype or the class labels of the samples. It contains information about the samples, such as whether they belong to a specific treatment group or control group. A CLS file is a tab-delimited text file that includes a header line followed by a list of samples with their class labels. In the first line, we write the number of samples, which is 4 in our cases, then a space, then the number of classes, which is normal and cancer, 2, followed by space, followed by 1. In the second line, we write the pound sign, then a space, then a visible name for each class. In our case, we will write normal cell and cancer cell. So normal cell and cancer cell. Then in the third line, we write class for each sample. We have normal samples and cancer samples. So we write normal, normal, cancer, cancer. Normal, oh, cancer, cancer. Now the GCT and CLS files are ready to perform GSEA analysis. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share the video, and leave your comments under the comment section. Until next time, happy analyzing.